Yeah. I know you're doing.
At this time, we're going to begin the services for Melanie. If you have your cell phones with you, I'm going to ask that you please check them before we begin to make sure they are on silent. And at this time, I'm going to invite Pastor Bob Briggs forward.
Dying, Christ destroys our death. And in rising, Christ restores us to our lives. Christ will come again in glory. As in baptism, Melanie put on Christ. So in Christ, may Melanie now be clothed with the glory that Jesus promises us all. Here and now, dear friends, we are all God's children. What we shall be has not yet been revealed, but we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Those who have this hope, as we all do, purify ourselves as Christ is pure. Now remember, Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life, and those that believe in me, even if and when they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me, in fact, shall never die. Jesus gives us this assurance. I am the Alpha and the Omega, he says, the beginning and the end. I am the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore. And I hold the keys of hell and death. And because I live, you shall live also. Brothers and sisters in Christ, friends, we are gathered here this morning to celebrate and to remember the life of Melanie, our beloved sister, our significant spouse, our mother, our friend, our daughter. We come to this place to share with one another the grief, the sadness, the pain that we may feel. But let me assure you, through these promises that Christ has made to us that I have read from Scripture, death is nothing but a doorway that Melanie has now went through. She has transitioned from this life to life eternal and into a life where she has a spiritual body that has no pain, that is free of any human suffering. And in fact, I'm slightly envious of where she has gone, and that I hope to join someday and be there where she is. We come to witness to the faith that we have and to celebrate Melanie's life. We come together in grief and we acknowledge that this is our human loss. My prayer is that God may grant us the grace that is His love, that in the pain that we find ourselves, we may find comfort. In sorrow, we may find hope, for it is assured to us that in death, we will find resurrection. Would you hear and be with me now in an attitude of prayer? God, who gave us birth, you are ever more ready to hear than we are to pray. You know our needs before we ask, and you know our ignorance in the asking. But we pray now, give us your grace, that as we shrink before this mystery that we know of as death, we may see the light of eternity. Creator God, speak to us once more your solemn message of life and of death. Help us to live as those who are prepared to die. And when our days are accomplished, enable us to die as those who go forth to live, so that in living or dying, our life may be in you. And nothing in life or in death will be able to separate us from your great love in Christ Jesus our Lord. Eternal God, we pray this. We praise you for the great company of all those who, like Melanie, have finished their course in faith and now find rest from their labor. We praise you for those that are dear to us, whom we name now in our hearts before you, and especially we praise you for Melanie, whom you have graciously received into your presence. To all of these, we ask you, grant your peace. Let perpetual light shine upon them and help us so to believe where we have not seen, that your presence may lead us through our years and bring us at last to be with them into the joy of your home, not made with hands, but that is eternal in the heavens, and we know it through Jesus Christ our Lord. And let the family say, Amen. I had the opportunity to come and be with many of you yesterday evening as we had the hours of viewing for family, for friends, for acquaintances. And I was asked, isn't it difficult? Or how difficult is it to do a funeral service for someone that you had never met or didn't know? And my answer was simple and twofold. First off, Marvin Cody is a member of my church family. And Melanie was his beloved daughter. So therefore, Melanie was part of my family too. And secondly, this service that we're having this afternoon, this is not for Melanie. Though we gather to remember who Melanie was to each of us, this service is for us, so that we may begin the healing process that death impacts on us. We grieve, we mourn, and that leads us from this time into celebration. of remembering who Melanie was for us and what she did for and to us and how she brought the love of the family and shared it with all who knew her. Her words to you, the family, to her friends, to her work acquaintances, were always supportive, understanding, and encouraging. I don't need to have known her to know the truth of that statement, for I did get to know her through your kind words and your descriptions that you shared with me. They helped me understand who Melanie was and how much she loved her friends, her family, and the community where she lived and worked. I was comforted by those words, as I am comforted by some of these words that we find within the scripture and that I've chosen to share with you in her name. Two favorite psalms from the book of Psalms. In Psalm 130, it says these words, "Out of the depths I cry unto thee, O Lord, and say, Lord, hear my cry. Please let those ears of yours be attentive to the voice of my supplication. For if thou art Lord, and you should mark iniquities, Lord, who could stand? But I know there is forgiveness with thee, that thou may be feared. I wait for the Lord, my soul waits, and in his words do I hope. My soul waits for the Lord more than those who watch for the morning. No, Israel, hope in the Lord. For with the Lord is great mercy. With him is plenteous redemption. And he will redeem Israel and us from all of our and their sins." And the 23rd Psalm, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He does make me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul and leads me in the path of righteousness and does so for his name's sake. And even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, still I fear no evil, for I understand God is with me, and his rod and his staff comfort me. And he prepares a table before me in the presence of mine enemies and anoints my head with oil. My cup runneth over, and I know that goodness and mercy follow me all the days of my life, and I dwell in the house of the Lord, and I dwell there forever." And find comfort in these words, found in the New Testament in the Gospel. These are selected readings from the Gospel of John, the 14th chapter. "For it was Jesus himself who said to us, his disciples, do not let your hearts be troubled. I say, believe in God, and then believe also." Remember, Jesus is speaking. He says, "Believe also in me." For Jesus tells us, "In my Father's house there are many rooms or dwelling places. And if it were not so, I would not have told you. But I do tell you that I go and prepare a place for you. And I promise, if I go and prepare a place for you, then I will come again, and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may also be. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Again, he promises us, I will not leave you orphaned or abandoned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world is going to no longer be able to see me, but I promise you, you will see me. Because I have lived, you will also live. Jesus says, I have said these things to you while I am still with you. But the Advocate, the one I send, the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will continue to teach you everything you need to know and remind you of all that I have said to you. And then Jesus said, peace. I leave with you my peace I give to you. And I do not give to you as the world gives. No, do not let your hearts be troubled. And do not let them be afraid. As I alluded to earlier, my belief, my faith is that the pain in death is only the pain that you and I feel. Melanie is released from all suffering and all pain. She has transitioned through this world into the next. And we gather for these final moments of ritual, the calling hours, the funeral, the internment. These are all places in the ritual where we get to recognize the finality of her physical death here on our earth. But because the body is buried, in no way means that Melanie is gone. For Melanie will always be with us and will be with you. And the way to make Melanie's smile radiate in a room again or to hear her laughter is by telling those stories of her in your lifetime. As long as we continue to mention and remember Melanie by telling stories of family gatherings or events taking place, if we share those with one another, then truly Melanie is never, ever really gone. I'd like to offer the opportunity for that storytelling to begin even now, and would offer anyone here the opportunity, if they wished, to share a memory or a moment that they've had with Melanie, or a remembrance of an event that took place in the life or in their lives together. It's a time of sharing your grief, your sorrow, or your joy and happiness. But feel no pressure. Those stories will come. And if no one cares to speak this morning, that's also okay. But I would give anyone now a moment, if you have a story or a memory to share it with us now. Please, you want to come up?
No, I'm fine here.
Okay.
I would just like to thank this family for giving me the honor to be with Mel for 18 months. During the first few months, Melanie was a kisser. She wanted to kiss all the time, and So she would kiss me on the cheek when I come in and when I go out. That habit kind of faded, and she didn't do it as much. But when I was with her at night, when I put her to bed, I would say, "I love you, Mel." And she'd say, "I love you back." And she'd kiss me. So I will never forget Mel and her family, who have made me feel very special for allowing me to take care of her.
Thank you for your service to the family, too. And if you were a member of my church family, I would say, well done, good and faithful servant. Well done. There's a song that we'd like to let you listen to, and as the words are sung and the song is played, reflect on your memories of Melanie as we hear the song "Here Without You" by Three Doors Down.
Colder, and I don't think I can look at this the same.
I'm here without you. I'm here with you until the end. I understand through conversations with Marvin that Melanie had came and attended the Big Flats United Methodist Church with him on occasion sometime before I started serving there. And there are members of the church family that remember her and the work that she did for our church family. Don't let anybody find out that you're good with numbers or in accounting. You know, if you're good with the books and you come to church, you're going to wind up in the finance team. And that's where she is remembered the most, by Jim Piazza and Jim's wife, Melanie. She touched our church family for a little while through attendance with Marv. And Marv has touched me, his pastor. It will only be 2 years in July, but I feel as if I've known Marv for my whole entire life. And when he shares his stories and tells the stories of his family, as he shares stories with me of Melanie, I know that his family and the family that Melanie created and the extended family that you all belong to is a family of love, family of compassion, and a family dedicated to helping one another. So I encourage you to help each other as you continue the process of mourning the loss of loved ones. Continue to share stories of who Melanie was and is to you. Continue to offer one another love and understanding and compassion. The emptiness, the pain that we feel in our hearts that comes through our loss will lessen, but never totally go away. And that's okay, because even though we may be here without you, we certainly never shall forget you and who you are to us. Melanie, rest. Take your rest. You have earned it. And wait for us to come to those many dwelling places that Jesus has prepared for us. Celebrate with us when we join you the victory that we have all had through Christ's sacrifice for us on the cross. And understand that we know we will see you again. Brothers and sisters, will you pray with me? God of us all, we understand that your love never ends. When all else fails, you still are God. And you are our God. And we pray to you for each of us and one another in our need. And we pray for all anywhere who mourn with us this day. I pray, Brother Jesus, Creator God, Comforter, Holy Spirit, I pray that those who doubt, you give light. To those who are weak, you give strength. To all who have sinned, give your mercy. To all who are in sorrow, Grant us your peace now and forever. And this we pray in your name. Alleluia. Amen. My only final word this morning or this afternoon is understand that Phil needs to continue to feel your love. I'm sure Marvin does. I'm sure the family does. Continue to offer your comfort and your support and your love freely and call upon Jesus the Lord to send his spirit into the mix. And if you have that faith, you will be rewarded. Alleluia. Amen.
I'd like to start by thanking Pastor Briggs today for his prayers. And on behalf of Melanie's family, I want to thank those of you who are here today in support. And as Pastor mentioned, please continue to keep her family in your thoughts and prayers over the upcoming weeks and months. This does conclude the services today. Just the immediate family will be going to the cemetery for a private committal service. So those of you who won't be attending, I invite you to come forward to pay your last respects before you exit the funeral home today. And lastly, those of you family members who will be assisting as pallbearers today, I will give you further instruction out in the foyer when you're ready. Thank you.